Welcome back to Let's Play Song of the Ocean Blind, now heading to the town of Giraffe, believe it or not. Madryn Road, I'm looking forward to checking out the, spiny shell turtle thing. Looking forward to checking out the towns of, hippo and rhinoceros as well. Kidding. Just checking for any chests or goodies that may be laying around. What the hell is that? Like a flaming tree stump? Well, this is probably the way to Giraffe, and then over there is something else. Let's go check that out. Oh, it's absolutely nothing. And what about over here? Nothing there as well. Alright. Let's fight the... I'm curious to see what these things are about. We will attack. Fire tree and bomber beetle? I surprise the enemy. I just noticed that little icon to the left of the name. Fire, fire. I don't know what that is. That mean... Yeah, I don't know what that means. We should use fire to against these enemies. But that's a fire tree, or maybe they use fire. Well, let's attack Metal Crab Steam. I got low magic for Jan here. Here. Yeah, we're not using our surprise round effectively. Well, at least I got rid of one of them. I'm experimenting with ourselves and letting the fire tree attack us. See what that will accomplish. Another one down. He shot the armored thing. He hit the tree for 120. Fire spark. Ahem. 10. Let's interrupt the turtle. Yeah, you thought you were gonna attack us, didn't you? Didn't turn out that way. Let's finish off Metal Crab A. So we should rest in Giraffe if there's a place to rest. Assuming there will be. Just to get Jan's magic back, if nothing else. Okay, it wasn't hard at all. 90 rills though, that's pretty good. Yeah, we're alright. Okay. Along the coast, which is where this town is. How fast? You didn't think a tree could go that fast, huh? I mean, it's really just a stump. So they avoid us because we have the call bell on. We have it on Jan, the dog. If we take that off, they'll immediately go after us. If we put on the noise bell, they'll really go after us. Forte says, where's the entrance to the wind cave? Let's ask locals, says McBean. Giraffe, indeed. Interesting. Now there's the inn. Yeah, stay at the inn before I forget. 40 gen. Yes, my travels. Well, they just put this, like, aluminum siding. And it's nailed into the structure there. What to stop the rest from being... That guy looks very familiar. Is that the guy? Nope, that's Dagri. I thought it was the guy from the cliff. I thought it was Grandpa Lap again, before he was a grandpa. I've been thinking it's so boring here, but I just couldn't find the right timing to go home. The bartender is not so friendly either. What should I do? Bartender not friendly. Oh, let's experience that then. The Wind Cave? At the rocky stretch in the outskirts of the village. As the name says, the Wind Cave is a cave that the wind goes through. The wind's always swishing. Well, he wasn't rude to me. Maybe he just doesn't like you. Oh, who's this? Oh, he's an item shop? Flail hammer. Still haven't found anyone that uses these hammers. Is it Xiao that uses them? Hurricane dagger? Dagger with a twisted blade spins like a storm and severs with a light contact. Slender sword? Yes, not an improvement. See, like a general store, more like. Oh, we came from this way. Oh, all these stairs down. Goes back up to where we were. Oops. Don't worry, monster. We'll leave you in peace. All right. What else could be here? Don't tell me it's just this. An inn and a general store dude that sits outside. What about this? We can go this way. Oh yeah, here we go. Oh, hello there. Tack says, there's the wind cave on the outskirts of this village. The wind from the sea goes through the hole, so the wind is raging inside the cave. We'll be pushed back by the wind and not be able to advance unless we change the flow of the wind. Besides, having two entrances are troublesome. We won't be able to go deep inside if we don't use our brain. So we have to change the flow of the wind. So our challenge with the lightning shrine was lightning. Now we have to deal with wind. Grandpa Tail says, there's a big lighthouse outskirt of the village. It's not used right now, so no one should be there. But I sometimes see human shadows. They could be ghosts. Ghosts, I tell you. Grandma Termina says, "Oh, I'm so bored. Is there anything interesting going on?" Not really, no. Separate beds, okay. Alright, so that's this place. What's a big, like, periscope or something here? That blocks our travel. Right. Who put that there? We should have them flogged immediately. We can go this way. It is a dead end. We can go this way. Misha says, "I saw something. I saw an old man in black going inside the lighthouse. Is he a ghost? Are the lighthouse and the wind cave in the same spot? Like, does the lighthouse go into the cave?" So this... Hold on, I just wanna... I think this goes back to where I just was. So I just wanna verify that. No, it doesn't. It goes over here where there's a barrel. "This keg smells fishy," says Fortang. "Let me see," says McBain. "Oops! If you smell it closely, it'll get you good. This smell is not from the salted clams." "That is not what I meant," says Fortang. Una says, "The keg prevents us from advancing, but it looks like the road is continuing ahead." "Yeah, I think this road leads to the wind cave," says Fortang. "We could move the keg, but we should ask the villagers of Giraffe first." Okay. I thought there was goods in there. I wasn't even aware that it was blocking the way. It's a good thing I checked that. Let's ask him if we can move it. "A keg of salted clams is my dad's new product. It really stinks." We can't ask this person. Maul says, "A keg? Oh, the keg is in your way? Sorry, but it's my husband's. I have told him before that it's in the way. I'm sorry." Oh, so he just ignores you, huh? Typical. Yawol, typical. Oh, it's Balkas. "Are you talking about a keg of salted clams?" "Yeah, I prepared it." "Sorry to bother you," says McBean, "but we want to go see the wind cave. Would you mind moving the keg to a different location for a while?" "Oh, okay, you're going to the wind cave. I didn't realize the keg was in your way. I'll move it right away." And there he goes. "I think we can get through if we move this much," Balkas says. "All right." "It's enough," says McBean. "Sorry to trouble you." "The wind is strong around the wind cave, so be careful." "Thank you," says Una. Well, we're not going yet, because I don't know if we've explored this whole place. "Some parts of the wind cave get strong wind, and the monster might appear as well, so be careful." The monster? The monster? Do I sense a boss battle imminent? Talk to these people again. Get back here. I wonder if anyone would buy salted clams. Like, I mean anyone. Well, you're... Or, is that it? I'm not sure if that person is related to Balkas or not, but... Balkas certainly hopes so. "The salted clam stinks, so we don't know where to put it. I'm sorry. Put it outside, away from the passage, or whatever. The planks. They put these things there so we can't go all the way around the town. I mean the... If I'm not wrong, the lighthouse is over there. I don't think it's worth going there. I want to see the lighthouse. I guess we have to go to the lighthouse after the cave? I'm gonna restart the recording because it's skipping here. Oops. Alright, who else can we talk to? I want to talk to a couple people we've already talked to and see if anything's changed. Oh, that's Balkus. I mean, these are interesting ways, but it's like kind of like a meandering path just to get to wherever you want to go. Sometimes you just want to go straight there. And that's not a thing we can do. Yeah. Ghosts, yeah, I want to check out the lighthouse. So bored. Alright, nothing new there. That's a dead end there. What if I can get down here? Yeah. Yeah, we're back here. You can stay or you can go. Should I stay or should I go? That's his question. So I'm trying to find out if this... Is that it? The town? Can't help but think I missed something. What, three houses? I mean, that's fine if it's just three houses, but I don't want to miss anything. There's a way down here. Oh. I haven't been over here. Have I? These are the same people. They're the same people. So that's where that goes. Oh, we can't get down there. So this might be it. It might be nothing else. Just being extra sure about it. See, like, to the left there, is that where I just went for the second time? I think so. Yeah. I guess that's it. I guess that's the entire village. I think there's three, maybe four houses. Alright, we're going to this wind cave then. If I can figure out how to get back to that area. Okay, hold on a second, not that way. Really, that must be very hard to walk. Can you imagine these things just bobbing up and down, back and forth as you're walking? I mean, maybe they're attached to the ground, or they're laying on the ground, but it looks like they're just floating in the water. I just imagine walking on such a thing. So we go this way. Oh, We're over here, okay. That's the stairs down that we took that I thought I found a new way, but didn't. So I guess what? No, I guess that must be the wind cave. I guess that's why it's called Giraffe, because it's all built up high like that. What's it called? Like Aqua Giraffe or something. Oh, there's another entrance. Which way are we supposed to go? Unless it plummets straight down. The guy's saying that you just use one entrance and use our brain or something. But which entrance should we be using? Giraffe Cave. Oh, it's even speckled like a giraffe, kinda. McBain says what? Ah, ha ha ha. It blows him back out. We gotta go in the other way. Forte says, ouch. The wind was so strong, says Una. It was an awful gust, McBain says. Well, what should we do? Go in the other way. I just want to see what happens if that happens again. Wow. So I think it's named after the cave? Okay. Let's go in this way and use our heads. We don't lose, no. See if we actually lost any hit points from that. So far so good this way. There's no wind here, or it's the wind is pushing us this way. Okay. Some kind of lever. Forte says wow again. Oh. Are we gonna... Oops. McBain says, I was about to fall into the sea. Yeah, Una, I know the wind is strong. Alright, we gotta pull that lever, obviously, before we go all the way into that passage. It's a lever. Pull down? Yes. Forte and his friends pull down the lever. Oh! Then we get blown out this way. We were blown away pretty far, says Forte. As soon as the door closed, the wind blew into us, says Una. Evidently, the name of the wind cave is derived from it, says McBain. Well, it's called Giraffe Cave when we go in. The wind was blowing straight through the pass. By closing the door, the wind had nowhere to go, so it had to blow toward us. Huh. So now, it happens here. Yes, the wind is strong. So we'll try going in this way. I'm not sure how far we can get because there's a door that we had to close. Yeah, that's the door we closed, so we can't even go this way at all. And apparently there's some kind of monster here. Saving. So if you just walk out here, wow. Ouch! We are back to the entrance again, says Forte. When it says the wind is strong again. Well. Oh. We're back to that entrance. Wait, which entrance is this? Do we still have this one over here? were blown out of the other one. Alright, let's use this. Good God. Back this way? What if we made both of them impassable? Okay, so that's already pulled down. It should be fine. That's closed. That's a teddy bear? Forte says, look! Something is floating over there, says Una. Yeah, it's a teddy bear called Bang Bang. Una extended her hand and picked it up. It's a stuffed animal. What kind of stuffed animal? Forte and his friends obtained a teddy bear. Is this Bang Bang? Says Forte. I bet it is, Una says. But why here? McBain says. We do not know. There's another door. Does that mean there's another lever somewhere? Oops. I gotta check out the teddy bear. Ah! Says Forte. An empty chest? The chest is already open, says Una. There's nothing inside, says Forte. Says McBain. Judging from the tricks inside the cave, I'm pretty sure Leon hit a resonance stone here. I wonder if someone else came here before us. Grandpa, what should we do? We can't do anything for now if it's not in the chest. Even so, it was worth coming here to find out it's not here. It looks like someone opened it recently. If we ask around to the locals of Ecuil or Giraffe, we will find some kind of clue. Let's start over. Right, says Forte. There are cases in the past that someone else had the resonance stone before us. McBain says, we should expect to encounter this kind of happening once or twice. Let's go back to Rosette's house once. Okay. Once? Once what? The chest is empty. Empty, empty. Teddy bear. Stuffed animal Tabby was looking for. The fluffy bear is popular among kids. Plus, you might just end up with two of them because Rachel's making another one. And there's another way to go. Oh, no, there isn't. Forte says, ah! Did it get blown away? Oh, are we looking at something? Oh, there's a numero soldier. Lord Berriger, sir. Necros is at the Giraffe Lighthouse. Oh, Ambassador Berriger. Did he spell it different in his dialogue? B-E-R, I think. Oh, he's camping out the lighthouse, huh? What an appropriate place. I think I had a special accent for him. Forte whispering, that's Berriger, who is working with Rish at Riotam Island. Yep, he's a scoundrel. Ah, eh? Says Una. Why in the world is he here? And who's that? Oh, there's Necros. Oh, look who's here. Ambassador Berriger. No, long time no see. I'm worried about you, since I haven't heard any rumors since you failed the operation on Riotam Island. Hehehe. I didn't come all the way here to listen to your sarcasm. The race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong. More opponents showed up than I expected. You could be a victim tomorrow as well. Ill-omened. What's happening to the puppet master from Ekul?
Don't worry. I just sent the soldiers off to pick him up.
Yeah, it makes sense to have an evil voice for Necros. Forte saying he sent the soldiers off to pick him up? Oh no! Rosette's in danger, says McBean. Are we supposed to run back to Rosette's workshop, or are we supposed to apprehend these people? Or are we supposed to ask people about the stone? I can't get there from here. Well, we'll look around and talk to people anyway, whatever. I saw something! The soldiers from somewhere are gathering at the Giraffe Lighthouse. What's gonna begin? Oh, I guess now we can go that way. I'm sure there's no timer or anything. I mean, it seems like there would be. The salted clams were done pretty well. Maybe I should try to dry them. I guess these people won't say anything about the stone until we finish off the lighthouse thing. I saw people in military attire going toward the lighthouse. I wonder where the soldiers from. Where were the soldiers from? I'm afraid the numeros have started to appear around here, too. So you don't care, so let's talk about the clams. Alright, so that's one house, right? Suspenseful. House number two. I just saw the soldiers. What are they doing at the place like this? The place? There's a big lighthouse outskirt of the village. Oh, he said that before. Never mind. I heard you threw a joyous performance in Ekul. Why didn't you tell me in advance? Sorry, says Una. We didn't know you. Time moves one way, linear. Okay, so house number two. Otherwise we go back to the past and tell you about it. Let me down. I think we have to go back up to... I think we have to go back around. I'm not sure. There's probably two ways, but this is a way I know. We'll go over here. Oh, no it isn't. Never mind. We have to figure it out ourselves without going back to ground. Alright, so... There's these two houses, and I think it's just the inn. So I wanted to ask around the inn. See if they saw anything, right? And this is a dead end down here, isn't it? Poor cat's trying to keep up. I don't even use the cat for anything. Sad to say. It's a small detail. This way? Seems good. Alright, third house. Or building, whatever. You found a stuffed animal? I wonder why it was here since this place is so deserted. This kind of thing could happen, huh? Being on a vacation is boring. But I came here to be bored, so I shouldn't complain. You came here to be bored. The sound of the wind blowing through the wind cave is slightly different depending on the time and season. A fine day and rainy day are different. A happy day and sad day are slightly different. I'm such a poet. And you didn't know it. Alright, that's it. Now we have to find out the way of the lighthouse again. Oops. I think... is it this way? No. I think it's from this platform to the left here. It's just a matter of finding out how to get to it. Well, this is the way of the wind cave, isn't it? Right? There's no other way, no. Oh, we don't gotta go to the lighthouse yet. McBain says, I'm worried about Rosette. Let's go back to Ecul. I agree, says Forte. Let's go, says Una. Okay, so this is the way. Good to know. Alright. I'm gonna call an episode here, actually. And we'll go back to Rosette's workshop next time. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.